Good evening and welcome to Verdict. Our focus tonight, from Orissa to Odisha, will it now be West Bengal to Bangla, Delhi to Delhi, Ahmedabad to Karnavati? Is changing names of states and cities back to their regional avatars righting a historical wrong, an assertion of regional identity, or just a pointless waste of taxpayers' money? Joining me on that debate tonight, a panel of different and very articulate voices. From Bangalore or Bengaluru, we've got U.R. Anantamurthy, well-known Kannada intellectual and writer. From Kolkata, Navanita Dev Sen, writer. I'll also be joined by well-known young actress Konkana Sen, also from Kolkata. From Ahmedabad, one of our leading cultural and social observers, Professor Ashish Nandi. And with me in the Delhi studio, Tathagata Satpathy, Biju Janata Dal MP, and editor of the popular Oriya Daily, The Dharitri. Thank you all very much for joining me. Say West Bengal, and the immediate question is, where is East Bengal then? Well, East Bengal became East Pakistan and is now Bangladesh, but West Bengal's name remains unchanged. 10 years ago, the State Assembly passed a resolution renaming the state Bangla and duly wrote to the centre demanding the name officially be changed. But nothing happened. Now with the renaming of Orissa, the focus is back on Bangla.
10 years ago, Calcutta became Kolkata. The state government could make that name change by itself. But the State Assembly's bid to change West Bengal to Bangla got stuck somewhere in Delhi. The desire for the name change is, however, undiminished, at least for this theatre personality who was among the people to press for the new name.
It was previously Central Province, but now it's named Madhya Pradesh. Nobody calls it Central Province. Nobody calls it North Province. Uttar Pradesh. It was Upper Province and now renamed as Uttar Pradesh. But only in West Bengal you will find that we call it by a translated name altogether.
But there are some who have a problem with the new name proposed, Bangla. They feel it is really the name of a language and more. They would much prefer the name used in the national anthem, Bongo.
I would have preferred Bongo, but now I hear it's Bangla. Bangla is the name of a language. But why should we suddenly bear the name of a language? I don't see any reason why. Besides, Bangla has an extremely important connotation. It's a great local wine. It's called Bangla.
Clearly, Bengal is divided on what West Bengal should be called. But that the name should be changed is a unanimous sentiment. In Kolkata, Monivipa Banerjee, NDTV.
On Verdict tonight, Orissa to Orisha, West Bengal to Bangla, does changing the names of states, cities really help assert regional and cultural identity? SMS us India Space Yes or India Space No to 56388. You can also log on to NDTV.com and join this debate on Verdict Live. Well, let me begin with Mr. Satpathy of the Biju Janata Dal, and the state government's proposal has officially been passed by the cabinet, so the BJP should be happy. But I know you've written an editorial in your paper where you didn't agree with this name change. Tell us why.
My problem is I have two roles to play. First is I'm an editor of a huge language daily. Second, I have to represent a constituency, Tenkanal, in the parliament, and I am a member of the Biju Janata Dal. My point is that if a word like Bombay was not pronounced by Maharashtrians as Bombay but Mumbai for ages, changing the name from Bombay to Mumbai makes sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
But Oriyas per se never said Odisha or Odia. We never did that. And it doesn't actually change in the Oriya language. It just changes in English and Hindi, which have no relevance to the millions of Oriyas living in Orissa.
That's very interesting.
So, first of all, we never pronounced it the way it is written in English. And secondly, changing our state's name or the people's nomenclature, whatever you call it, in English and Oriya, in English and Hindi, actually has no relevance, first of all. Secondly, what I object to, or what my problem is, it's not my problem, but what I see as a problem, is that the amount of expenditure that goes into changing these names should also be transparently put before the public.
Yes.
and an opinion sought from the general people before a change should be taken into
consideration. And did they want it in the first place? Let me bring in, you are Anantamurthy here from Bangalore, and somehow even though this city's name has been officially changed, I've seen that Bangalore, Bengaluru, it really depends which language you're speaking in when you talk about that city. Do you agree with the view that changing the name of a city or a state is rights a historical wrong? Why do you think this is actually so important?
You know, there is one official name, there is unofficial name, another. And the common people use the unofficial name. I just wanted some power to the common people, so that the name they use becomes an official name also. But I am not a fool to think that Bangalore will disappear when once you have a Bengaluru. There will be two towns for the people who can speak English, who are well-traveled. Bangalore will still exist. And for the people which have always used, Bengaluru will be the name. This is true of Bombay. There are two towns, Bombay and Mumbai, Kolkata and Calcutta. I think this is an Indian reality.
That's an interesting point, because you're talking about the coexistence of many different identities, a part of a unique reality which is India. But let me bring in Professor Nandi here. Professor Nandi, you've written extensively on this, and you've talked about how we should preserve our plurality of identities rather than trying to wipe out one with the other. Do you feel that in the way sometimes names are changed and is used by political parties, that we are in the danger of trying to replace one with the other?
Yes, absolutely. I find it particularly silly. And my suspicion is this, that this is done only for political reasons. All great cities have more than one name. Mm-hmm. Nobody goes to die in Banaras or Varanasi, they go to die in Kashi. But nobody wears a Varanasi sari, they wear a Banarasi sari and eat Banarasi paan. Mm-hmm. And Calcutta, Kolkata and Calcutta is used by millions of people. Mm-hmm. And Kolkata is the regional Bengali name, and yes, I think it should be given salience and official status. But that does not mean that you change the name of Calcutta to Kolkata.
Yes.
You simultaneously give legitimacy to Kolkata, Calcutta and Calcutta.
I think that really is the challenge, especially among certain streams of political thought. How do you keep these different identities existing together? Let me get in Konkana Sen, an actress who's migrated in a way from Kolkata now to Mumbai. Konkana, we saw the recent controversy which your film Willy Nilly got involved in over the use of Mumbai and Bombay. Why do you think the city names, right, state names have become such a political issue today?
That's exactly what it is, Sonia. I think it's just a political issue. I don't think it necessarily, represents what the people want. There have been no demonstrations or protests that, you know, we have to have the name changed. And I agree with all of them, with the points that they made earlier. When I speak in Bengali, I say Kolkata. When I speak in English, I say Calcutta. And I'm equally comfortable in both. And I do think that, you know, I understand the sentiments that certain people might feel that it's a colonial burden or something. I personally don't feel so easily threatened. My regional identity is not so easily threatened, but, you know, people do feel it, and I think that is valid. And we have changed the name. We've changed names everywhere. But the thing is that, you know, I think that in the people's life, the change has happened in our own lifetime.
Yes.
So it's going to take us some time to get used to it. I don't think that future generations will necessarily face the same problem.
But is it a generational thing, Konkana? Because when we talk about this colonial burden and legacy, it's really from a generation different in a way from yours. Yet we find young people seem to find it insignificant, but then neither do they stand up and protest when political parties try to hijack this whole name-changing issue. They don't stand up and say, we want the right to call our city Bombay, or we want the right to call our city Calcutta.
That's because, I think that there's apathy among young people everywhere. They don't voice many other more important things. A name change, I don't think, is anyway such an important issue.
It's interesting, because that's a
not
change.
To me.
I remember when we were young, it was the opposite. It was the young who were kind of driving all the movements that were and felt very passionate about things. But you're right, maybe a name change doesn't affect the current young generation's life. But let me bring in Navanita Dev Sen at this point. Ma'am, as somebody who's talked about the different identities of Kolkata, Calcutta, as you would put it, why do you think this debate is currently so important in terms of reasserting a cultural identity? Do you feel it is?
Honestly, I don't think Kolkata will make any difference to our cultural identity. Calcutta and Kolkata are just the same to me.
Mm-hmm.
As Konkona said, when speaking in English, we say Calcutta. In Bangla, we say Kolkata. And we don't feel different at all. And actually, you know, when Kolkata is pronounced on the on the air, for example,
yes,
all kinds of mispronunciations are heard. Kolkoto, Kolkato, and everything.
So the non-Bengalis are murdering it, you're saying?
And
the non-Bengalis like me are murdering it.
We are not supposed to use the word non-Bengali. It's politically incorrect.
Oh no.
But however, there is such a thing. No, but actually, I really think it really meant a lot of waste of paper and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It was not an absolutely necessary thing. But
right,
as far as Bangladesh is concerned, I felt very hurt,
mm-hmm,
when the name Bangladesh was hijacked. And because we all,
yes,
felt that Bangladesh is the place name for us too.
Yes.
So suddenly we realized that Bangladesh is not our country anymore.
Mm-hmm.
That was something we should have stood up and objected to at that time, but we didn't.
Yes.
And so Bangladesh is gone. Postal Bongo, I'm very much against.
Yes.
Because there is no Purva Bongo.
Mm-hmm.
Something when the East does not exist, the West is an extra burden.
So the logic behind this whole,
meaningless, really.
The logic behind names, some rightful ones hijacked, what to call the new one. Let me just bring in Mr. Satpathy here. Well, different views, all making the point that it doesn't really matter. So tell me, as a politician, and now in your avatar as a representative of the BJD, why do political parties care so much about this?
I am at a loss to understand what really irks people about a name. And who started this game? I think it started in Delhi, because for all wrongdoings in this country, Delhi is primarily responsible.
Spoken like a true regional politician.
Yes, and they started. Now, I have an umpteen points to prove also. They started renaming the roads, first of all. Then they started writing the names in three different languages, to appease minorities, to appease the upper crust of Indians, and to appease the locals. So why don't we stop calling English English anymore? Let's call it Angrezi. You make it legal.
Where does it actually end?
That's it. So today, NDTV cannot be called NDTV. It should be called Naya Delhi. What would be television in Hindi? I do not know. Some yantra or something. Let's call that.
Don't ask me. But that's an interesting point. But while we've talked about how it's irrelevant, there's also a more dangerous trend. And that, of course, is of regional chauvinism. We're going to take a quick break now, but we'll be back on that right after this break. Welcome back. Our focus on the verdict tonight, changing the names of states, cities. Is it an assertion of culture and regional identity? Well, I'm joined by my special panel. And just going back to you, Professor Nandi in Ahmedabad, it's interesting you're there, because I remember you writing about the fact that sometimes, while we may dismiss this name-changing spree as silly, it can also be dangerous. And we know the state government's proposal of trying to change the name of Ahmedabad to Karnavati has other connotations as well. Do you think we are ignoring that in this kind of dismissiveness of what does it matter if you change a name?
Yes, I think it is, frankly speaking, a totally wasteful effort. And in any case, Bombay doesn't become Mumbai for those whom it is Bombay. I do not agree with Navanita Calcutta and Kolkata are the same. Navanita herself can navigate both Calcutta and Kolkata, but there are a lot of people who live only in Kolkata, and a majority of Calcutta's working population lives in Calcutta, neither in Kolkata nor in Calcutta. Bombay film industry is in Bombay, not in Mumbai.
Konkana, the Bombay film industry is in Bombay, not in Mumbai. Is that part of the clash? Is Bombay or Mumbai, as you call it, really so many different worlds, as it were?
Yes.
Right, exactly. And then there's also Bombay.
Exactly. At Kashi and Varanasi are not intercastal.
Yes. Konkana, I'll readdress that question to you. When you, I said there's so many different worlds in Bombay, Mumbai, and if you would just continue with that description of the separate worlds.
I was just saying that there's also Bambaiya. I mean, it depends what language you're speaking in. I think that there are people, I mean, I personally, it's always Bombay to me. And Bombay is also, it's become a cultural phenomenon. There's, you know, I mean, next you'd be calling it, you know, Mumbai duck instead of Bombay duck. And, you know, Bombay dying and companies like, you can't take Bombay away. It's been there. I mean, if you have to change it, then I think that we should be a little less rigid about it.
So were you disappointed when Karan Johar actually apologized to Raj Thackeray about using the word Bombay? Were you disappointed with that?
Well, I mean, I don't really want to comment on that, because I think that, you know, people must do what they feel is right.
Right.
And, you know, and I'm pretty tolerant about other people. If someone wants to call it Mumbai, that's great. But if I want to call it Bombay, I expect to be, you know, that freedom of expression to be extended to me as well.
Mm-hmm. And it's not just actually Bombay and Mumbai. We've seen this trend of, you know, regional groups, regional parties trying to force the use of a particular word in Karnataka, where we've seen that whole movement against the use of Tamil, etc. If I can bring in Mr. Anantamurthy again, sir, when we talk about the coexistence of cultural identities, what about the danger of regional chauvinism, especially when you've seen it on the rise in a state like Karnataka with groups like the KRS?
We are always in danger of falling to the trap. But I shall tell you something very interesting. In Mysore, we have a Crawford Hall. They try to change the name, but it's still Crawford Hall for common people. There is a road in Bangalore called Kengal Hanumanthaya Road. He was a great hero, and he was our chief minister. He was a railway minister also. Nobody calls it Kengal Hanumanthaya Road. They call it Double Road. So the common people use what comes easy for them. And hence there is no danger of chauvinism so far as the inarticulate, common, ordinary people of India are concerned.
But
there are interested groups which change this into that kind of extremism.
So has this whole issue of perhaps writing, as I said, historical wrongs, of bringing back earlier identities, has that cause actually been hijacked by groups in Karnataka and Raj Thackeray, the Shiv Sena in Mumbai?
Yes, but we should resist that. Mm-hmm. I, for instance, speak not only for Bengaluru, but also against people who make this into a kind of fascist attitude. We should not tolerate it. But, you know, we should be ready to call all these towns by the name that the people are really used to,
yes,
so that we pay our respect to the common people and the language in which these words seem so consonant.
So don't impose it artificially.
Correct. Whereas Bangalore, in a Kannada sentence, looks wrong.
Right.
Bengaluru, in a Kannada sentence, looks good.
flows naturally with the language. Tathagata Satpathy, are you going to go back and tell Naveen Patnaik, why did you send this silly proposal to Delhi?
No, let me be honest, I don't have the guts to do that. There's no point in...
He's got a Democratic Chief Minister.
No, he is. But why would I do that? It's not just his thing. That
yes.
is the government, the cabinet has proposed it. And
yes.
it's, I think everybody is involved in that.
Mm-hmm.
And I cannot exclude myself from that sitting here because I am a member of that party.
Yes.
But yet, as an Indian first and foremost and as an Oriya, I will say simply that no Oriya pronounces it as Odia. No Oriya ever says Odisha. And There is no point in going through so much of expenditure. One little example is, what will happen to the car registration plates?
It's an expense of 100 crores, I think, to change all the,
yes,
names.
A perfunctory thing says that stationary than what you have on the boards, billboards and everything.
And in a state like Orissa, that could be put to much, much better use.
It will be about 130 crores, 140 crores.
Yes.
I would say let's invest that money in drinking water and agriculture.
Of course. Well, those are good words to end on. Thank you all very much for joining me tonight. Navanita Devsen, Professor Nandi, Mr. Anantamurthy, Konkana Sen and Mr. Satpathy. Thank you all very much
for joining
me on the show. But what have you, the viewer, voted in? What do you feel? Does changing the names of states, cities really help in asserting regional identity? Well, your final verdict coming up, 75% of you say no. Will the politicians listen? That's it on the show tonight. Keep watching NDTV for all the latest news updates. Goodbye.